So now I would like to welcome the leader that sparked all this activity by tweeting, "How can I help?" Mr. Francis Suarez, mayor of the city of Miami, also joining with Moishe Mana, founder and chairman of Mana Common, and Saeed Amidi, founder and CEO of Plug and Play. Gentlemen, go ahead.
Thank you so much, Jackie. It's great to be here with you from not so sunny California today, but every time I have been to Florida and to Miami, I felt great with the diversity of the culture and the energy that is present there. And, you know, just to give you a little background, I did the traditional businesses like real estate, packaging, and bottled water up to about 25 years ago, and then started investing in few startups per year. And I never, it was my hobby. It was what I enjoy doing the most. And, you know, a few times when we made a big difference in the entrepreneur's journey, I realized that I can help more entrepreneurs either by funding or by connecting them to other people. And I want to just share with you that we feel we could connect Miami with Silicon Valley, with Paris, with Munich, with Tel Aviv, and all parts of the world. And whenever you want to do something of substantial impact, you need to have a group of people. So Moishe, it has been a great pleasure meeting you and seeing your vision to build this community. So welcome. Maybe you can share with us some of your early journeys. I am sorry, you are on mute still, Moishe.
Thank you very much, Saeed. Very, very impressive what you have been accomplished in the last year since ever you started your journey. We have very similar journey, you and I. I started as a moving and storage operation, and but then we continued on and we're here today. So thank you, Mayor Daniela. Thank you, Mayor Francis, for coming in here. Thank you. Hi. And okay, so this being a journey here. So I started also as a moving guy, dishwasher, the whole story. But then again, I moved on in my life and I got into the meat packing and we built the milk studio, and this was a big catalyst for the milk, for the meat packing to become what it is today. During the years, I've done many things: fashion, art services, technology investment, real estate, agriculture, and so forth. And it's not 10 years ago, it's over 10 years ago already, because I came here 2009, so years are folding, you know, so fast. So when I came to Miami, and this was in the midst of the recession, I totally understood that we need to do something exceptional. And the problem is that every time there is a neighborhood built, then come the real estate fund and really basically destroy the whole ecosystem. So I said, we're going to buy a big critical mass of real estate, and we're going to build a sustainable community where we do not need to trade with the real estate. This is a home for the brain. This is a home for creation. This is a home for changing city. So along with it, my journey to come and uncover why Miami, what Miami is about, I was astonished how really the possibilities that Miami represent for people, you know, because Miami is an international city, multi-language. We're sitting across the Panama Canal, next to 700 million people, Latin America. I call it the invisible continent. 50 million people goes through the port of Miami, 20 million visitors, and I can low taxation, great weather, and so forth. So I didn't understand why Miami is the way it was 10, 12 years ago. And I got to the conclusion, and my conversation with Mayor Daniela Cava at the time, when before she got elected, and I told her, Daniela, you know, the issues with Miami is since the last 100 years, since Henry Flagler established Miami as a tourist destination, nothing changed. In between was Maurice Ferre that came and put it on the map as the capital of Latin America. But we did not have a vision. And here we go. Now today we have a vision. Today we have a plan. And we're going to start with simple thing, with a building, with a neighborhood where we can build a community that can thrive the whole city. This is going to be the economic engine of Miami. So us as a group, at the Mana Common Group, we not only we build the real estate, we invest and we help the businesses coming into our community to become better, become bigger, and to become more sustainable. And our job, Saeed, very, very similar. Our vision, very similar to your vision as far as what you're doing. But we're doing it from Miami. You did an incredible job with your vision. It's so similar. And the idea is to collaborate. All of this, what we are building, collaborate with organizations like yours to make Miami where Miami is supposed to be. It is across the future of the Americas is one. The future of North America is embedded in Latin America, 700 million people there. And now the world want to connect to Latin America also. They're sitting on the last land reserve and they all got apps and they all got computers. So I figured through Miami, we can create this incredible hub, international hub, where we bring Europe, we bring the Middle East, we bring the Far East, we bring Latin America, we bring North America into one ecosystem. And that's what we've been doing. I don't want to take much more of your time, but this is the vision and we are going forward and we are building and we got few, and this is in terms of the food, the entertainment, the art, the fashion, and innovations sitting in the center of everything that we're doing. Thank you very much for everybody, for the efforts and everything that we are doing here, all of us here together. And don't forget the immigrants. The immigrants are the catalyst of this economy, okay? So this is a little bit of political clue. Thank you very much, everybody.
Mayor Francis, I always like to add little stories, you know, about 4 years ago, President Jokowi of Indonesia visited me in Plug and Play headquarters. And as he was leaving, he held my arm and he said, Saeed, you have to open Plug and Play in Jakarta. And a year later, we opened Plug and Play with the four largest industrial group people in Indonesia. And then we connected it to Singapore, to Beijing, to Shanghai. You know, I would love to ask you, like, if we set up shop in Miami, which big cities in Latin America or US would you like us to connect these, you know, funding, business development? What is your thoughts about the biggest partners of Miami?
Well, I agree with Moishe. You know, I think that Latin America, Central America, and South America are mega markets. And I think one of the things that's great about Miami, and we're so grateful for your investment in our city and your decision to come to Flagler, which we feel is going to become one of the premier sort of Sandhill roads of Miami based on your leadership and based on Moishe's vision. I think there are so many different cities within Latin America, obviously, on the and then the sort of Latin American side, you have Mexico City. In South America, you have Bogota. You have obviously Buenos Aires. You have Chile, which I think are very strong economies. Uruguay, Paraguay. I visited. It's an interesting country in the middle of South America. So I think there is really no place that you don't have access to with a direct flight, which is one of the things that I think is exciting about Miami. Miami, you know, our former mayor used to say all the time, you can't fake our geography. And we are a direct flight away from any city in the United States, any city in the Caribbean, any city in South America, any city basically in Europe, any city in the Middle East. And we're going to increasingly have a footprint in Asia and India. So I think in terms of your position as a company, I don't think there's a better place to be. And I don't think that there is a country in Quito, of course, in Ecuador, there's not a country in South America you're not going to have direct access to. And I've been very blessed in my my time as mayor to know, you know, obviously Brazil is enormous, an enormous economy. You have Sao Paulo and Rio. I've hosted the Brazilian president here. I went to the inauguration of the Colombian president, Iván Duque, and I've been asked to campaign in Argentina for the Argentinian president. And I serve on a board with the Chilean president. So, there really is a strong connection between South America and the U.S. And I think Moishe is totally right on that issue. Totally, totally right. And I think, unfortunately, companies have ignored Central and South America for too long to their detriment. These are mega markets. The eastern part of our world are going to become mega markets as well.
You know, if I can share with you, as I always like to share, you know, stories about 4 or 5 years ago, we started investing in Latin America, specifically in Brazil and Mexico. You know, one of our startups, which is TruckPad out of São Paulo, Brazil, is like the Uber of trucking. And recently it was worth around $600 million, and it created, I believe, close to 1,000 jobs. And the other startup that we are very proud of, it's called Rappi, is the largest delivery company in Latin America that it started out of Colombia. And I remember when the founders came to my office in California 6 years ago, and they started with the e-commerce site, then went into delivery and then focused on delivery. So we really hope for these new unicorns, they will come to Miami and make it a hub to grow into US and vice versa. A lot of the big technology companies in US will have a office in Miami to serve Latin America. And again, it will be fantastic to be part of not only large corporations' journey to digitalization, but also the startups that would like to serve all Americas. So I will turn it to you, Moishe, to see how many technologies companies did you meet in 2020? I met a little bit over 1,000, if you believe it or not. And we helped almost all the 1,000 that went through some of our programs. And as Jackie mentioned, I think we invested in around 150 of them. But I'd love to see how can I get you hooked to invest in more technology companies.
Okay, first of all, we've been investing in technology companies for the last 20 years. I've been investing in technology companies, but very, very interesting what you said, because you and I are very much on the same page. Okay, because me traveling to Latin America and interviewing companies and meeting them also in Silicon Valley and where they're sitting, I totally understood that Latin America is very, very fragmented. That's why they cannot build unicorns, because when they looked upon, when they be sitting in Silicon Valley, in the back room, it's only 25 million people economy. It's only 10 million people economy. So they didn't look at it as a continent economy. So me traveling and interviewing these companies, and if it was in Mexico, if it was in Colombia, or it was Brazil, wherever it was very, it's, I totally understood the fragmentation of this these companies, of these countries. So I figured if we bring them to Miami, build an ecosystem for them, and then they can collaborate among themselves, and the world is not going to look at them as a 50 million people economy or 20 million economy. They're going to look at them as 700 million. So if Brazil worked next to Peru, Peru works to Argentina. So when you do it, when you do an application, when you do a project, it's becoming automatically because of the physical location. And I came more than this. It's very ambitious what I said. We are going to build the digital infrastructure of Latin America from Miami. This is what needed, because the access to investors, the biggest problems of these companies many times to have access to investors. And once they're going to come to Miami, once the brain will be here and the arm going to be over there, then we can build something sustainable. I mean, something big can change the whole life of these 700 million people. Because these people are, I call it the invisible continent, the invisible people. But many of them now, they got apps, they got computers, they really like to go to school, they do their homework. And I'm going to give you a little bit heads up. By the way, you invested in the right place, in the logistic. Logistic in Latin America is really very big problem everywhere when we go, especially I saw it in Brazil about 8 years ago when I was there, the issue of logistic and how they do what looks for us simple was complicated over there. But you're right on track. You're very right what you said. And I'm giving you a bit heads up, and that's what we've been investing in agriculture. We're going to have in the next 10 years huge problem with agriculture, with food. 3.5 billion Chinese middle class coming in, with the global warming, some, you know, much land going to come out the assembly line, and we are going to deal with a big crisis of food. And it's not like the pandemic, you can solve it in a year. It takes to grow avocado 5 years. So we've been investing in this, and logistics is a big part of it. Consolidations through Panama and sending from Panama back to the Far East. This is something, a project that we like to work on, and we can collaborate working on it, and creating the Panama-Miami connection, which I reached to the president of Panama, and we're working together, creating the Panama-Miami Western Hemisphere global trade hub. Because together, we have 1.2 billion people. Miami sitting right in the middle of this 1.2 billion people economy. So providing a huge opportunity for any investor, for any startup, for any individual who want to make a difference in his life and people other people's life. That's what it is. We're on the same page, Saeed, you and I. Same page.
Excellent.
I'd like to keep in touch with you and see how we can work together.
That is great. Like on personal. That is great. Mayor Francis, any closing remarks before I turn it back to Jackie?
Well, first of all, thank you for this wonderful opportunity to spend some time with you and with Moishe. You both are tremendous visionaries. What I found so interesting about some of the things that we're talking about off the air, and I hope I'm not violating any confidence by talking about it, but you talked about your strategy and you had invested in these 150 companies, and a few of the companies went really, really big, made it really, really big. And I think what happens is the investment, when you're investing in tech, it's a different strategy. And what's exciting about Miami is now you're gonna have this massive migration from New York, combining with this massive migration from Silicon Valley, understanding these mass markets like the ones that Moishe was talking about of South America and Central America. But I think it's even bigger than that, if I can be so bold and say that I think when we fully integrate the Indian culture and the Asian culture into Miami, two cultures that are growing but still need a long way to go in our city, once that diversity completely takes hold, then I think Miami is going to be much more than just a portal to Latin America. We will always have that portal to Latin America. Why? Because we are a naturally Hispanic city. We have, you know, 10 plus, maybe 15 Hispanic subcultures here in Miami. So that connection to Latin America will never wither away, will never die, will never weaken. What's interesting is we're going to strengthen connections to India, strengthens connections to Asia. We already have very strong connections to the Middle East that we're going to continue to grow. So what I see is, as in terms of the bullish nature of the future, we were talking about this a little bit, Saeed, before the meeting, is I think Miami can really position itself, if we're smart, as one of the most powerful, and I don't like to use the word powerful because powerful is probably not the right word, but one of the most influential and important cities in the world, if everything goes right. And my mission is to make sure that that happens, because it's not just about me. It's about my children. It's about the children in this community that don't have what my children have, and making sure that they're going to have an opportunity to be successful in our city. That's my challenge. And income inequality is the challenge of our generation. And I look forward to tackling that challenge with a lot of energy and a lot of innovation.
Very, very powerful last words. And I'm sorry to jump right in here, but I really wanted to take over for the actual next panel. Well, Mayor Suarez, thank you so much for being here.